Belinda Audio presents this unabridged recording of Board Shorts, written by Margaret Clark and read by Mark Mitchell. The book contains a dedication for Julie with love. Chapter 1.
I'm ripping down the world's biggest wave at 6 metres, I swear, a wall of sheer water power. I'm flying, man. It's the ultimate ride of my life. I'm barreling. Bring, bring. My eyes jerk open as I wake up and gaze at the 3.5 metre walls of my bedroom. Yeah, what a wave. But only in my dreams. Wipe out. Because I'm not surfing at Kuta, at Bali, or Cloud Break at Fiji, or the pipeline on Oahu. I'm actually lying in bed at home in good old Australia, listening to the surf report.
And it's going to be a beautiful day for you surfers out there, just waking up from cloudland.
Yeah.
A steady offshore breeze on the west coast, with a solid swell and waves to 1.5 metres. A perfect surfing day, with the best waves at 13th, Bankura, Winky Pop and Bells. This is Rob the Rattler telling you all to have a great day.
Yeah, what about a great day for all those schoolies like me who want to hit the surf and can't? I hate school most of the time. OK, is there anything I like about school? Well, there's my mates, Mikey and Flash. Yeah, and there's... Well, there's my mates. I can't think of anything else. Oh, yeah, choice chocolate donut with jam inside at the canteen. What don't I like about school? Being stuck inside all day, having to sit still all day and listen, and there's no surf. Surfing's my life. I've been surfing since I could stand up in the breaks on the shore and catch a wave on one of those little boogie boards. My dad's a surfer from way back. He's got a longboard, which means he can hang 10 and do a pile of stunts, and he says it has the drive, the speed and the glide that the shortboards don't have. It causes some light-hearted rivalry between us, because I'm a shortboard man myself. So are my mates. I mean, you look like a kook if you're on a long board, even if you can surf really well, unless you're, like, old. Dad reckons my board's just a fat snowboard with a fin, although when he gets on it, he rips. But then he rips on anything. See, Dad reckons to be a top surfer, you need to be a waterman. That means good at everything to do with the water. He reckons a surfboard's a tool, and a good waterman should have a whole toolbox full of equipment so that he can hone his skills in the water. A good waterman, and waterwoman, should be able to swim well, body surf, body board, scuba dive, handle a boat, paddle a kayak, the whole lot. That's probably why my dad's nickname is Mad Dog Morgan, because lots of surfers think he's nuts. My nickname's Pup, son of Mad Dog, Pup Morgan. Nobody ever calls me by my real name, Paul. Everyone, even the teachers at school, call me Pup. Anyway, what I want to say is that there's one thing I know about school. There are no waves and no surf. That is, except on Fridays. And that's when the PE teacher takes a load of kids surfing for a sports elective. But today's Monday, which means 4 more days till we go surfing. I can't stand it. I go and stand at the window and look out over the sea. We live near the surf. The best surf's usually at Bell's Beach, which isn't far from where I live. The sea draws me like a magnet, and I stare at it from my bedroom window. It's going to be a top day, and the swell's perfect. Why, oh, why do parents, teachers and the law say that kids have to go to school? Hurry up, Pup, Mum calls down the passage. Your food's getting cold. Okay. I drag on my school shirt and shorts and wander out to the kitchen. Mum's cooked eggs, bacon and tomatoes, my favourite. I guzzle 0.5 litre of juice and get stuck into the food. Oh, you eat like a pig, says Sarah. Sarah's my older sister. She's neat, clean, tidy, loves school, hates surfing. You could say she's the exact opposite to me. Dad's on night shift this week and it's a 40-minute drive back here, but he'll be home just as I'm leaving. He can get some Z's, then hit the surf. Lucky him. Unlucky me. Mum works part-time at the milk bar and she doesn't start till 10. She could get in some fantastic early morning breaks, but she hates surfing. Neither Mum nor Sarah could understand why Dad and I love our surfing more than practically anything in the world. Because we live down the coast, Sarah and I have to get a bus to school. But even though we have to travel every day, I'd rather live on the coast than anywhere else on this planet. Well, maybe Hawaii. And then I could surf the pipeline. The surf's supposed to be awesome. Hurry up, Pup, or you'll miss the bus, says Mum. What a good idea. Why didn't I think of that?
Chapter 2.
I'm standing at the bus stop. Sarah's raving on to her friend. She's got millions. Me? I've got Mikey and Flash. That's it. I go to an old boys' school. Unless you're a legend on the footy oval or a cool cricketer, you might as well be dead. Mikey and Flash love surfing like me. They hate school like me. There's these groups at my school. So if you're a computer nerd, you can hang with other computer nerds. They've even got a nerd club at our school, and everyone just calls them the nerds. If you're a bookworm, you can be a library lizard and hang in the library. In fact, a lot of guys, especially the ones who hate sport, like to hang round in the library. They're called the lizards. There's this group who cruise round looking tough and beating up the younger kids. They smoke on the oval big time. Flash said they carry spray cans so they can do a bit of tagging if they get a chance. The railway yard's their favourite place. Basically, they're standover merchants. It gives them something to do with their day. That's the thugs. Then there's the tryhards. They sort of slope round, trying hard to blend into the brickwork when the thugs cruise past. They also follow the teachers on duty and volunteer to help with chores and stuff. Some of the tryhards are brainy and others try hard to be brainy. Of course, if you're good at sport, you're really rolling along nicely, especially if you're a real sports jock and you're good at athletics and footy. So they're the jocks. If you're brilliant at ping pong, that doesn't count at all. Then there's the leftovers. The leftovers are boys who might have a couple of mates like me, or no mates like Bartholomew, who never talks to anyone. I don't know whether all boys' schools are like this or not. I've only ever been to one. Pup's not a good name to be stuck with either. It's a cool name if you're a surfer, but not a good school name. Bartholomew, who comes from Lancashire in England and sounds like a junior jagger when he talks, says it so it comes out Pup. Of course, the thugs are right onto it. So they call me Pup as well. The nerds call me Puss. The jocks don't know I exist. It's a mongrel gig at school. The bus stop's a pretty mongrel gig too. There's about four or five girls who catch the bus with Sarah. They go to the all-girls school, which is maybe why they act a bit dateless and desperate. Hey, Pup, giggles this dipstick of a girl called Sally. Wag your tail for me. It's an old joke. I ignore her. Come, Pup, she goes. Show us some tricks. Yeah, bite my bum. This other dropsical called Emma bends over in front of me and wiggles her backside. I think girls are the weirdest, man. What's with this lot? I mutter to Sarah as the others collapse into a giggle fest. When are they going to grow up? Sally's in love with you? Oh, whatever, I shrug. I can see the bus coming, slow as a turtle with four broken legs. Can't it hurry up? Want to go out with me? Sally's gazing at me with eyes like a set of headlights on high beam. Suddenly, I get a horrible feeling that she mightn't be joking. Maybe she's for real. No. Rejection, she screams. How can I live? She clutches at her heart and staggers backwards. What a loser. But at least she's not for real. They're all older than me, so I know they're just taking the mick and having girl thing fun.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.